Tell me about meditation.
Gosh. Well, I know you meditate.
Yeah.
Okay, so, and I know lots of people meditate and get a lot from it. Mm-hmm. And my father meditates for hours.
Mm.
Okay, and he says that it's, and he's 85, right?
Mm-hmm.
That it is the most blissful thing he does.
Mm.
Okay. And I've tried it. I did a course. I've tried focusing on breath. I've tried focusing on a point. I've tried it with my eyes closed. I've tried it with my eyes open, right? And I couldn't get it, right? I couldn't see the purpose of it, mm-hmm. because I think my mind is generally quite still anyway.
Yeah.
And I'm quite good at focusing on stuff. So I couldn't see why I was doing it.
Yeah.
Right. So I think you have to know why you're doing something before you do it, right? My father would say, no, you don't have to know. He would say to me, take my word for it.
Yeah, I agree.
Anyone who meditates,
yeah.
right, will get the benefit.
I agree.
Right?
Yeah.
Just by doing it, you will get the benefit.
Yeah.
Right? Maybe I'm not quite old enough yet.
I think that your life is a meditation.
Well.
So the purpose of meditation, I guess, as you were saying, is to be present, right? To be very present in every moment, to connect to the stillness within, so the right answers come, so right action comes.
See, I don't buy that.
See, I buy that, because that. But you do that in your waking life.
But, no, what I don't buy is this idea of something being right.
No, there is something that's right. Moving in the way of your soul is right. Moving in the way of love is right. Okay, so maybe love is the word. When I meditate, that day, I move in the direction of love instead of the direction of fear.
But you choose love, right?
Yeah, you choose love. But when you don't meditate, your mind can be so foggy and filled with fear.
Possibly, okay.
And the reason why you don't get it is you always choose love. You always choose love, as far as I can see.
Right. But
so you do that anyway. But for people who don't do that anyway, because I'm not blaming it on doshas at all, but like being a Vata person,
you can be, yeah,
when
exactly
you're
right.
off balance, you will come from a fearful place.
Yeah.
Meditation brings you back to that
sure,
place of not being fearful.
Right.
Of anything.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
you have nothing to be fearful of.
Yeah.
Everything that you're fearful of is an illusion. And meditation makes you recognize that. But the reason you don't need it, or perceive to need it, is I've never known you to feel fear.
Well, of course everyone feels fear.
Yeah,
you'd
be fearful if you saw a shark now.
No, in small things. I mean, if you spend your life watching TV, you know, and eating crisps, and not being out of your comfort zone, why would you feel fear?
Oh, that right? sounds good.
Right? Why would you feel fear? So, of course, as soon as you push your boundaries, the definition of pushing boundaries is
fear.
Feeling the fear and doing it anyway.
Absolutely.
Right, so, as someone
but
once
you
said.
Do, yeah, what's her name? Susan Jefferson.
Yeah,
but
Jeffries.
Jefferson.
What's it?
I Know It's Me self-help book. So, I think that what it's given me is, yes, you're right, you recognise fear, but fear does not control you, you control it.
Yes, but the reason that is, right? And I think maybe this is the thing.
Yeah.
Well, you let go controlling, obviously,
yeah.
because you can't control.
You
there's no such thing as control.
No.
But I do, and I say this, and I know you find it really frustrating, is I think everything is perfect.
Yeah, no, you're right. I don't find that frustrating.
But
I take your point, and some days I want to say no. And when I meditate, I want to say, yes, I hear you, sister, because it is, right?
It really is.
It really is.
I mean, for us and people like us, more than most,
yes,
right?
Absolutely.
You
we
know,
don't know how blessed we are.
So,
yeah.
apart from the physical realm, right, and it's easy for us to say because we are blessed,
yeah.
but I think at any given time, whatever your circumstances, it is perfect.
Absolutely.
And you know, why is it perfect? Because why would your life be anything other than perfect? Why would you spend your time living a life that is not perfect?
Yeah, or kidding yourself that it's not. Because then you are kidding yourself. And I think that goes back to why we started Morley. If you don't honour yourself, you don't see the perfection. Because you've really not looked after, you've not honoured your soul. Therefore, a things are not going to be perfect. Because you've not looked after yourself to get
again,
to the
this
place.
Is a control thing, right?
Why is that control?
You think you can do things to make your life perfect?
Yes. No. You can do things to see the perfection in your life.
That's possibly true.
Yeah, it is true.
Yes. So you've come to this, my life is perfect. The fact I don't perceive it as perfect is nothing to do with my life. It's to do with my mind. Yes.
So if I give myself time, like those Morley moments in the evening that I'm addicted to, I have to have my bath with the salts and I have to light my candle and I have to take five and meditate. That brings me back to, gosh, yes, it is perfect. There was just a mask.
But what if you can't
mask?
Do that one day? Let's say something happens. Let's say water comes in through the roof, so you can't do that, okay?
Then I think that if you do it long enough, one day, it will become so habitual to feel that way.
Yes.
That you won't need to do
it.
Yes. Yes, but that one day comes at different points for each of us, right?
I accept that.
So you may be there, right? Partly because you're married to me, darling. Or you may not be there.
So the water can be coming through the ceiling, okay? If you have to deal with that, right, that is perfect, right? Because you're spending part of your life dealing with the water coming in through the ceiling, right? Why would you perceive that as being anything other than perfect?
I get that.
What a waste of your life
I get
to do something that is not perfect.
No.
If you're coming through the ceiling,
deal with it. Yeah.
And believe that that thing you're doing right there is the thing you're meant to be doing at that time.
Yeah.
And because your life is perfect, doing that thing is perfect.
I agree with that. And on the converse, what you mustn't do is think that all I deserve in my life is to be cleaning up mess. And that again comes back to knowing that you are so bright and big that there's a whole universe out there to claim if you want it.
Oh, sure.
It doesn't mean you should want it.
Yeah.
That's up to you, but what the converse is, you shouldn't think that my life is.
You deserve everything.
You deserve everything. Like, right. I had a point of being addicted to cleaning. Many of us do, because it's a distraction.
And it's control.
It's control. When you have no control in your life, cleaning gives you a start, middle, and end, right?
Yes.
It gives you a resolution, yeah? And I didn't want mess in my life because I needed everything to be perfect, but that's a superficial perfect. And now I recognize I don't want to spend my life cleaning. I just don't want to do it.
Sure.
You know? It's fine to do it, but not all the time.
I think we need to take a wrap there.
Yeah.
Yeah.